So what is the last topic we have read? I think we completed magic numbers and nuclear cell model. So that is very important one. I hope that you have practiced it properly. Any doubt you have while finding out magic numbers?
No, sir.
Okay. So today we will discuss another topic that is called interaction of heavy charged particle with matter. Okay, basically we will discuss about alpha. Here heavy charged particle is your alpha particle. So basically in this topic we will discuss about the interaction of charged particle with matter. So how many kinds of interaction can happen? So before we begin, let me tell you the range of this interaction will be, the energy range is from 0.1 to 5 mega electron volt, and this kind of range is basically Coulombic interaction. Okay, so whatever interaction we will deal now, there is an alpha particle interacting with matter of the atom. There is all Coulombic interaction. Because see, from the nucleus, whenever there is any radiation, how to detect whether radiation has taken place? That radiation or that particle should interact with the matter of the atom. Okay, let's say electron. So now when any charged particle will interact with matter, am I audible to all?
Yes.
So whenever any charged particle will interact with matter, then what happens? Ionization will take place. That is called ionizing radiation of nucleus. So high energy photons or electromagnetic radiation which are emitted from outside the nucleus. Okay. Basically, like we say, X-rays are emitted from the process outside the nucleus. But if you talk about gamma rays, then that originates inside the nucleus. Okay. So here the interaction is of many types, basically three types actually. So first one is called heavy charged particle interacting with matter. Next is light charged particle interacting with matter, and another one is gamma rays interacting with matter. Okay. So today we will discuss about the heavy charged particle interacting with matter. Let's say electron. So what matter is here? This matter is the electron. So matter here is electron. And this charged particle, heavy charged particle is alpha particle. Okay, so alpha particle will be interacting with matter with a range of 0.1 to 5 mega electron volt, and this kind of interaction is Coulombic in nature. So let me just draw a schematic diagram to explain. Let's say this is your x-axis, this is your y-axis, and let's say this is the electron present here. Okay. So this is the electron, and another charged particle, heavy charged particle, is presented somewhere here, let's say. ZE. Okay, and this is alpha, so it is positive. And this is electron, this is, let's say, alpha, and this is connected, let's say this is the distance. Let us assume this is the distance. Okay, it is not possible to draw properly. Aap isko r maan lo. Okay, so this distance is your r. Distance from this alpha particle with electron. This is your alpha particle. And this alpha particle is moving towards x axis with certain velocity, that is v. Okay, and the distance from here to the origin is, let's say, x, and the distance from here to the origin is, let's say, b. Understood? So this is interacting, so the force, let's say, in this direction. So the diagram is clear to all?
Yes.
Everybody has drawn it?
Yes, sir.
So now, when it is interacting, what is the momentum or what is the impulse experienced by this charged particle? It is equal to change in momentum of the object. You know what is impulse? Okay. So let us find out the impulse of this due to interaction. So impulse is given as, one more thing is, I will find out impulse in terms of y direction only. That is equal to f of y dt, and integration goes from minus infinity to plus infinity. The reason of taking this y axis is because if you resolve the vector, you will get one of the component in this direction. Okay, if this alpha particle is left hand side as per the diagram, suppose the alpha particle is situated somewhere in the positive x axis and it is moving towards x, like suppose, for example, it is situated somewhere here and moving towards x axis, then you will have the component towards right hand side. So as a result, both will cancel out each other, okay, because there is equal probability of finding particle here. So in that case, your x component gets cancelled, okay. So we are left out with y component. So I will find out impulse with y direction, Iy, that is equal to Fy dot dt, and this is given as, what is the formula for F? It is Ze multiplied with electron, that means E, isn't it? So Ze, E, that is Ze square, divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r, and r square, and this is sine theta d theta, sorry, d t.
Okay. Sir, एक doubt था.
बोलो.
Sir, यहाँ पर हम लोग दो alpha particle consider कर रहे हैं ताकि वो उसका horizontal component cancel हो जाए. तो फिर हम लोग यहाँ पर two लिखेंगे ना sir, two z e dot e. क्योंकि वो जो दूसरा alpha particle है उसकी वजह से भी.
This is in general I'm telling. When I will consider, see, heavy charge particle, we have considered alpha. Actually, the in general heavy charge particle can be anything. आपके syllabus के लिए मैं alpha consider करूँगा. So for alpha, your z is equal to 2, so you'll substitute 2. Then you get 2 e square. That you are talking, I think.
नहीं सर, उसके बारे में बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ सर. मैं बात कर रहा हूँ सर वो दूसरे वाले alpha particle की वजह से, जिसकी वजह से horizontal component cancel हो और vertical component मतलब सिर्फ रह गया.
नहीं,
तो वहाँ पर दो vertical component रह जाएगा, तो 2 sin theta.
हाँ. लेकिन वो इन जनरल एक्सप्रेशन है, लेकिन जब हम इंटरेक्शन की बात कर रहे हैं तो एट ए टाइम इट इज इंटरेक्टिंग विद वन ऑफ इट. So let's say it is interacting with this kind of schematic diagram. Okay. अभी हम सिर्फ इसके साथ इंटरेक्शन की बात कर रहे हैं, यहाँ पे जो है उसके साथ इंटरेक्शन की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं, इसीलिए बस मैंने इसी फॉर्म में लिखा। तो यूजुअली होता क्या है, व्हेन यू टेक द ओवरऑल इंटरेक्शन देन वाई कंपोनेंट ओनली एग्जिस्ट, एक्स कंपोनेंट गेट्स कैंसिल्ड आउट, अंडरस्टूड। लेकिन अभी मैंने सिर्फ इसके साथ इंटरेक्शन का लिया है, इलेक्ट्रॉन विद अल्फा पार्टिकल।
ओके सर।
ओके, so now if you proceed like this, so what is the limit? This is from minus infinity to plus infinity. So you understood this thing, z e square by 4 pi epsilon naught r square sin theta dt. And what is your theta? This is the angle, this is the theta. Okay, is it clear?
Yes.
सर वो ZD से ओरिजिन तक का डिस्टेंस को ये कर दीजिए, वो x कंफ्यूज हो जाएगा बार बार।
यहाँ से यहाँ तक x है डिस्टेंस।
सर उसको x के जगह कुछ और कर दीजिए, नहीं तो वो x कोऑर्डिनेट के साथ बार बार x x कंफ्यूजन हो जा रहा है।
हाँ कर सकते हो, यू कैन टेक एनीथिंग एज पर योर विश। कुछ कंफ्यूजन होने का है नहीं, क्योंकि वी आर नॉट कंसीडरिंग दिस एक्सिस एनीवेयर, वी आर नॉट राइटिंग दैट पार्ट। जस्ट आपके स्टेटमेंट में आप लिखोगे जी एक्स कंपोनेंट गेट्स कैंसिल्ड आउट बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ अनदर अल्फा पार्टिकल ऑन द अदर साइड, बट सिंस वी आर कंसीडरिंग राइट नाउ विद दिस काइंड ऑफ इंटरेक्शन, लाइक दिस अल्फा पार्टिकल इज इंटरेक्टिंग विद दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन एट अ सर्टेन डिस्टेंस r, एंड दिस अल्फा पार्टिकल इज सिचुएटेड एट अ डिस्टेंस x फ्रॉम द ओरिजिन, सो y कंपोनेंट ओनली एग्जिस्ट, सो iy एंड देन यू प्रोसीड। सो वट एवर x फैक्टर यू विल गेट हियर, x टर्म यू विल गेट हियर, that denotes the distance from alpha particle to origin, that doesn't talk anything about this x axis. Or if you are a little bit confused, you can take this as positive x, sorry, capital x, just for the sake of diagram. Okay, don't be confused with any x. We'll come across this x symbol, but that x symbol signify your distance from origin. That's it. Okay, so now since in our case the heavy particle, the heavy charged particle is alpha, so for alpha particle we know that z is equal to 2, so what will be your iy? This is equal to 2 e square, this is 4 pi epsilon naught r square, and this is sine theta and dt. Okay, and limit is from minus infinity to plus infinity. Understood? So you can see from this equation, you can put some equation number. Let's say this is 1, this is equation 2. So from equation 2, you see that we have how many factors over here, which IY is depending on, we have R, we have theta, we have T. So we have to write in any one of the form for having easy calculation. So from this diagram we will remodify this equation 2 and write in terms of any one of the factor. Okay, that factor will be in terms of theta. So humko r ko theta mein convert karna hai and dt ko bhi theta mein convert karna hai. This is our next step. Okay, because of easy calculation. So what I will do here is, from your diagram, what is your sin theta? Let's first change this one. So what is your sin theta? Sin theta means perpendicular by what? Hypotenuse? That is b by r, isn't it?
Yes.
So r will be b by sin theta. So now you see sin theta is converted. R is converted. B by sin theta. So theta form mein aa gaya. Similarly, dt. So here you see that for tan theta, if you take, then that is b by x. So you got x is equal to b by tan theta, or you can say b cot theta. And what is your x? It is a distance. So distance is speed multiplied with time, isn't it? It is speed multiplied with time. And here we will consider the speed is b. And since the alpha particle is approaching origin, okay, it is approaching towards origin, sign will be negative. Okay, so we will have speed is equal to, sorry, distance is equal to v minus v into t. So from that x is equal to minus v t, we have to resolve dt in terms of theta again. So two step modifications we need to do here. Okay, let us do the first one. So here, let's resolve r and t in terms of theta for easy calculation. So what we do here, sin theta is what? V by r. So this implies r is equal to V by sin theta, isn't it? Is it clear?
Yes.
So what will be your I, Y? Let us go one by one, okay? Otherwise you'll be confused. So let us first substitute this in equation 2. So I, Y is equal to, this is your 2E square by 4 pi epsilon naught, and r is what? V by sin theta. So r square is V square, and this is sin square theta goes up, and this is sin theta. So this is sin theta to the power cube, and this is dt. Okay, is it clear?
Yes.
So you got equation 3a, let's see. Now we will change into t. So t, writing t in terms of theta. So what we will do here, also we can see tan theta is equal to P by B, that means B by base. Base is what? X. So this implies X is equal to B tan theta, or you can say B cot theta. And we know that X is equal to Vt, speed into time. And since the alpha particle moving with velocity V is approaching towards origin, we keep minus sign there for that. That means x is the distance from center to the incident particle, and x is negative since speed is towards the origin. So x is equal to minus vt. So this implies, if you compare these two equations, so minus vt is equal to, this is what? V cot theta. So this implies dt is equal to p, this will be cosec square theta d theta, and v comes down, this is v, and this can also be written as, what is cosec square theta? Is v sine square theta d theta. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, I can also write this as d V sine theta whole square d theta, and I will substitute it in equation 3a once again. So from 3a, I will get Iy is equal to, okay, now since I have converted r and t in terms of theta, so my limit will also be changed. So let us see that what will be changed. Let us just write this part first. So it is 2e square, this is 4 pi epsilon naught, and this is b square, this is sine theta whole to the power 3, and now dt. So dt is what? V divided by v sine theta square, this is d theta. So if you take the limit part, so how to find the limit? So when your t is equal to minus infinity, theta is equal to 0. isn't it? When t is equal to minus infinity, theta will be how much? Use the equation here.
Yes.
So theta is zero. Another limit was what? This is one limit. Another limit was when t is equal to infinity, plus infinity, theta is equal to pi. So that means your integration is now from 0 to pi. All right. And if you solve it further, you will see that it is, this gets cancelled, b and b square. So after doing all this cancellation, you will get 0 to pi, this 2e square sine theta whole divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. 1b is here, and this gets cancelled, sine theta, b and v, and this is d theta. Is it correct up to this? Isn't it?
Sir, minus shift tha.
Minus kahin miss ho gaya?
Yes, sir.
Kahan pe minus tha?
Sir, wo minus vt likhe the jo. Phir uska dt equals to minus b cos x square theta. सर रिकॉर्ड का
मतलब यहां पे
यस सर
हां तो इसको अगर आप कन्वर्शन करो तो ये माइनस साइन साइड अब्सॉर्ब हो जाता है इसके अंदर ओके
वो अच्छा वो माइनस कोस एक्स स्क्वायर थीटा होता है
ओके सो अप टू दिस इट इज ओके सो यू कैन गिव ओके नो नीड टू गिव इक्वेशन नंबर जस्ट try to relate from this equation that this factors 2e square by 4 pi epsilon naught b v are constant factors. So I can bring this outside 2e square by 4 pi epsilon naught b v is a constant. So you are left out with sine theta d theta and you have to integrate it with from 0 to pi. So what is sine theta integration? Very simple. So the relation will be this is your 2e square whole divided by kya hoga answer? So if you substitute, I think this will get cancelled. So this will be 2 pi. So direct answer likho, aap log usko check karo. Okay. So this is your z e square, I'm writing in general. This is 2 pi epsilon naught dv. Okay. So what is the integration of sine theta? Sambit?
Minus 2.
Sambit, what is integration of sine theta? Okay. Aryan, what is sine theta integration?
The minus cos x. Hello, sir.
Sine theta integration kaun ho?
Minus chhod diya sir, sorry, minus cos theta.
Minus cos x.
Okay, now you put the limit. So what I have done here is I have written in general terms. Okay, that means here, okay, yes. So here I have written in terms of z, because in general for a heavy charged particle is the equation of impulse. So give equation number. What is the last equation number? 10 or 11. What is the last equation number, Atik?
Sir, 3a diye the, 3b nahi diye the, sir.
अच्छा ये 3b होगा फिर, ये 3b तो 3b करो एंड दिस इज 4. ओके सो इन जनरल वी गॉट दिस एक्सप्रेशन इक्वेशन 4. सो हियर व्हाट इज द मोमेंटम ट्रांसफर ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन. So this is the momentum transfer of the electron due to interaction. That means this momentum is achieved through electron due to close passing of a heavy charged particle. When an electron is encountering or when a heavy charged particle is moving very close to the electron, then this is the momentum transfer taking place. Is that clear? Understood?
Yes, sir.
So, momentum transfer of the electron is so this much of momentum is transferred when a heavy charged particle is moving close to the electron, or electron is moving close to the heavy charged particle. Anything, either this is moving or that is coming close to this. Okay. So what is the kinetic energy gained by the electron? This is the same as the energy lost by the heavy charged particle, isn't it? Either jab nucleus se koi radiation niklega, when it is interacting with the matter, either the electron will be completely ejected out, will be ionized, or else it will go to or jump to lower level or higher level. Okay, either these two things will take place. Either the electron will jump from higher to low, low to higher level, or it will be completely removed from its orbit. So this means that here the kinetic energy gained by electron is equal to this is the is equal to energy lost by heavy charged particle. Okay. So this is what? This is equal to P square by 2m. So what is the kinetic energy? It is P square by 2m. So what is the kinetic energy you will get here? This is equal to P square by 2m. And when you get energy in this form, we know that kinetic energy is half mv square, but you are writing in terms of p square by 2m. So it's the same thing. But when you write in this form, whenever you say that it is a relativistic energy, okay, you do not discuss about non-relativistic energy here. Understood? So during relativistic concept, energy can be written as E is equal to p square by 2m. So what is your p square? So if you do the square of this, you get Z square E4 divided by 8m pi square epsilon naught square V square V square. Okay. So that is equal to Z square E to the power 4 divided by 4 pi square epsilon naught square V square V square, and 2m is there. So one m will come here. So 4 pi, instead of that, I can write 8m. Okay, 2m is multiplied. So this is 8m. This is equation 6. So this much is the energy that is gained by the electron whenever a heavy charged particle is passing by the electron. Or you can say the reverse thing, this much is the energy lost by the heavy charged particle. So this is the case when one heavy charged particle is interacting with one electron. but in a system you can have many number of electrons. So let us find out how many number of electrons are there and how much energy will be lost. Okay, are you following or not? This is the energy for one interaction. Is it clear?
Yes.
So now we will find out what is the energy, that is total energy, how much. So we have to find out how many number of total number of electrons are present and how much energy will be lost. So now let us find out total number of electrons and how much energy will be lost. So for that we need to find out the energy loss per unit length by this charged particle. So whenever this charged particle is moving along x-axis, so how much energy it is lost, it depends on how many electrons it is interacting with. So for that case, let us assume that this is the we'll consider a cylindrical cell, and this cylindrical cell this is your x-axis. Okay, this is your x-axis. And let's say this part, the small part, let us assume that this distance is b and this distance is db. So db is the thickness, and in this db electrons are present. Okay, there will be a finite distance between the charged particle and the interacting electrons. See, it is not going head-on collision. That will be different story. If charged particle is going, it is head-on colliding with a electron. That is different thing. But it is not a head-on collision kind of thing. It is just passing near to it. So when it is passing near to it, it will have some finite distance from it. So let's say the distance is b, and db is the thickness inside which the electrons are present. So now let's say the charged particle is moving in this direction, x-axis, and let us say that this distance is your dx. Up to this. Okay, any doubt?
No, sir.
And from here, let us assume, since I told you that only y component will exist, then let us assume that this is your yx. So whenever the charged particle, alpha particle, is moving along x-axis, this is the alpha particle moving along x-axis, it is passing close to the periphery of this db where the electrons are present. So how much interaction it will have, or what is the energy, we'll find out. Okay, so it will interact with this electrons which are present in the range db. I hope the diagram is clear to you all.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so for finding out total number of electrons and how much energy is there, we need to consider a cylindrical cell of length dx, whose radius is let's say b, and thickness is your db. Okay, so dx is what? Dx is your length of cylindrical cell, d is your radius, and db is your thickness. Okay, let n is number of, what is your n? N is the number of atoms per unit volume. N is number of atoms per unit volume. And what is your z? Z kya hota hai?
Number of protons.
Number is number of electrons present in the atom, in each atom, or you can say number of electrons in each atom. And what is your nz? Number of electrons per unit volume, per unit volume. The unit volume mein kitne electrons present hain, that is your nz. So we will find out the volume of the cylindrical cell. Now, volume of cylindrical cell is equal to, this is pi d plus db whole square minus b square multiplied with dx. So can you relate this formula?
Pi r square l.
Can you relate this pi r square h? Okay, volume is what? Pi r square h. So this is b plus db whole square, b plus db whole square minus b square. So that means what? I need to find out this part only. So b plus db ka whole square, and this is the db. Okay, that means from O to A, this point, this O to A point is your b plus db, that square minus b square. Okay, and what is your dx? Length, pi r square h, or height you can say. Okay, so in that form I have written pi r square. So if you just solve this one, you'll get 2 pi b db dx. Okay, b square, and this is db square plus 2ab minus this, b square gets cancelled. So in this way you'll find out this value, b d 2 pi b db dx. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, so b square is getting cancelled from here. What about db square? I have not written db square anywhere. What happened to that? Sanjana? Yes? Sanjana?
Yes, sir.
Where is db square from this equation? I have cancelled that. I have ignored that. Why? Because db is itself a small quantity, itself a small value. Uska square aur bhi chota hoga. So we can neglect that. Okay. Db square is neglected. You should know the reason why it is neglected. Anyways, so this is the volume. So you can put a equation number. Atik, what is the last equation number?
6.
So this is your 7. Okay. Now, what is the total number of electrons in the cylindrical cell? Volume pata chal gaya aapko? Agar ek unit volume mein itna electrons hain, to pure volume mein kitne electrons hain? Simple. Therefore, total number of electrons in the cylindrical cell is equal to nz 2 pi b db dx. Total number of electrons present in the cylindrical cell is this volume multiplied by nz. I hope it is clear up to this equation 8. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
अच्छा, हमने थोड़ी देर पहले क्या समझा था, क्या पढ़ा था? हमने ये देखा था कि in the energy transferred from the charged particle during crossing the cylindrical cell is same as the energy gained by the electron, okay, in this cell. Is it understood to you the meaning of this sentence, this statement?
Yes.
So dE can be written as minus kinetic energy nz 2 pi b db dx. Yes or no? Isn't it, this is the energy which is transferred? Are you following or not?
Yes sir.
So kinetic energy lost due to interaction, this is the, in this process kinetic energy is lost, that means energy is transferred, or energy, that much energy is gained by the electron. So I can write this as mathematically, this implies dE is equal to minus z square e to the power 4 by 8m pi square epsilon naught square d square v square. I think this is the equation. I think just have a check. 8m baki sab square, yes. That multiplied with this value, that is nz 2 pi b db dx. Okay, this is the kinetic energy lost due to interaction. So from this expression you can see that if I find out d per unit length, okay, this dE per unit length, if I find, then dx will come to this side for per unit length. So whatever rest factors will be left out, those things are constant, that also comes out. So integration will be from for this dB, this is a change in the thickness, okay, rest other things are constant. Yes or no?
Yes.
That means I am going to write, this implies dE by dx is equal to, or else let me bring this minus sign to this side also. So minus dE by dx is equal to z square e4, and this is nz whole divided by 4 pi m 4 pi m, because 2 pi and this is 8 pi square cancelled, this is 4 pi. So 4 pi m, and what is left out? Epsilon naught square is there, b square, this is the b, so that gets cancelled. So left out is b, and this is your v square, and this one is dp. Yes, so this is left out. Okay, so that means what is this dE by dx minus dE by dx? This is the energy that is lost, or you can say that is the energy that is gained by the electron. Hamesha yaad rakho that heavy charged particle will lose the energy, as a result electron will gain energy, then only ionization will take place. All right, so from this last equation you can see that except this dB by B, all other terms are constant, because charged particle is coming with a particular speed, it is having all other things are constant. So V is not varying. What is varying? What can vary? Depending on the number of electrons present in the cylindrical cell, your cylindrical cell will have either a small radius, or that dB will have a thicker dB or thinner dB. That means basically B and dB is getting changed. That's what I mean to say. Okay, so from this expression you can see that am I clear to all? Are you able to understand?
Yes.
Sambit, Aryan?
Yes, sir.
Chandrama, Rutuja?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sanjana?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is all mathematical interaction, meaning calculations. This mathematical formula will only give you a proof that matter is interacting, or the charged particle coming out of the nucleus is interacting with matter, because unless we cannot trace it out. So mathematical formula is required. And different experiments are also done based on this formula. Okay. Okay, now let us solve this. So this implies dE by dx and a minus sign. That is equal to z square e4 n z divided by 4 pi m epsilon square b square, and integration goes from dB to b. And what will be my limit? This will be either b minimum and this is b maximum. What is the B minimum range and what is the B maximum range it will have? So dx by x integration, you know that is ln. Okay, ln factor will come here. So this can be written as minus dE by dx is equal to z square e4 nz divided by 4 pi epsilon 4 pi m epsilon naught square v square, and this is ln. So if you put the limit, it is b max by b minimum. Okay, what is the last equation, Sanjana? What is the last equation?
Sir, 4.
Atik, what is the last equation?
Number 8, sir.
What is the last equation I have used?
8, sir.
8.
Yes, sir.
So this is 9. Okay. So this is equation 9. Okay. So what is your dE by dx here? Here your this one dE by dx this is the energy loss per unit path length. Okay, this is also known as specific energy loss factor. Also, it is known as stopping power of the medium for a given charged particle. Okay. So in the next class, we will find out what is the value of this B max and B minimum. What can be the maximum range and the minimum range, this B, or the radius of the cylinder and the thickness where the electrons are present, it will be. So in the next class, we'll find out the range and then we will substitute those values. And final expression of this energy loss per unit length is what is known as your, in case of relativistic quantum mechanical treatment, this is given by Bethe-Bloch function. Okay, this is also known as Bethe-Bloch relation. So that we are going to find out in the next class. So we'll continue after this. So it is not yet over. So in the next class, we'll again try to find out the value of this B max and B minimum. Then we'll find out the final expression for Bethe-Bloch expression for stopping power. Okay, that means it will tell you the rate at which a charged particle will lose energy whenever it passes through a matter. Remember, here the charged particle is not interacting head-on with the matter. It is not a head-on collision. It is just passing through the close to the matter. So during that kind of interaction, it depends. Either it is going close to that or it is going farther away from that. Let's say this is the nucleus, and let's say here is the electron, and the charged particle is going like this. So this is now the distance. Now, when the next it is going, let's say during next, for example, this is the nucleus, and let's say this is the electron. Let's say the charged particle is going like this. So this is now the distance. This is now the distance. So this is B. Similarly, here B increases. So you can have a maximum B. So that doesn't mean that if this electron is present here, it will interact with this matter. So there is a limiting factor for B max and B minimum. What is the minimum range electron can come close to the charged particle, and what is the maximum distance that electron can interact with the charged particle? So those two things we'll find out in the next class. Is that clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us stop here. We'll meet in the next class to complete this equation.